renowned international alcohol reduction expert, clinical hypnotherapist and author Georgia Foster aims to help Kiwis halve their drinking habits. Georgia is going to be delivering seminars in Auckland and in Wellington, and she joins us now to give us some tips on cutting down on the booze. Welcome, Georgia.
Thank you.
What an absolute pleasure. Let's find out a little bit about you and your background. So you've just returned to Australia after many years of living in London.
Yeah, I lived in the UK for 22 years, helping people in Europe drink less. But, you know, I'm an Aussie and I have quite a few Kiwi clients when I was in London, that's for sure.
I can imagine you did.
Yeah. True. Well, I'm pleased you're here. How did you get into this line of work to start off with?
Yeah.
Why particularly alcohol reduction?
Well, I have a history of drinking a lot. I mean, I used to drink because I was socially shy, very anxious. It didn't help that my, you know, best friend was a model and everybody kind of, you know, I felt very unattractive. That's her issue at all. She's still my best friend. It's more to do with the fact that I used alcohol to be that funny, witty party girl.
You know?
And with it came the hangovers, the dreading the night before. And when I became a hypnotherapist, I trained in an amazing psychology, which is a very big part of the success of my work. I realised that the combination of hypnosis and this psychology training, which is all in the seminar, is about moving on. Like, I believe that some people go into therapy and that's right for them, but I'm more like a progressive therapist. I'm saying, look, there's nothing wrong with how you drink or what you drink. It's your thinking before the drinking that's the problem. And when I realised that I was just socially shy and didn't feel good about myself, and I was using the booze for that reason.
And you talk about reduction rather than quit, don't you?
Correct.
So why is that? Just that quitting's not realistic for people or not necessary?
I think most people don't want to stop drinking. Mm. There are certain people who feel they need to, but I say to people, you know, there's a big, you know, we're talking home drinking here. We're not talking bar, restaurant, cafe kind of things.
Yeah.
Generally, we're talking home drinking.
Right.
The kids have gone to bed. It's my time for me. I've had a stressful day. It's my treat. And I'm not saying not drink. But we've got to think about why we drink before we drink. And that's what's really key to the results that I have.
OK, so your work doesn't focus on alcoholics as such. It's more just people like me and I do what you just said. You know, I treat it as a reward. I've had a good day, I go home, day's done, have a glass of wine. 2 to 3 glasses of wine later, you know, you've gone through half a bottle.
And a lot of that's unconscious drinking. Is like, where have I been? Where's that bottle of wine gone?
Yeah.
And then, you know, often, you know, someone will say, my wife or my husband's come home, I've already had half a bottle to myself.
Mm.
You know, where have I been? And that's very much habitual, and that's a big part of my program is working on the habit, because it could be a packet of biscuits, it could be 5 cigarettes, same thing.
Half a bar of chocolate.
Well, I think the problem with alcohol, it's quite a taboo subject, so people feel shamed and guilty. I'm like, please, we've got to stop that, because, you know, my client base, people who come on my seminars, are people who genuinely are normal, fully functioning people.
Yes.
You know, they've just got themselves into a bit of a drinking rut.
Yes.
Yeah.
Drinking habit. So what would your top tips be then for if you want to reduce your alcohol intake? What do you need to do?
Well, first of all, understand what the triggers are. So keep an emotional diary.
Yeah.
Just keep it for 1 week. Is it because you're really stressed, or maybe you are socially shy? I mean, I think that's a big one. Boredom is a big trigger because when you're bored, you can often negatively think, and you think, oh, I'm just going to have a drink to shut down that critical part of the brain. And that's a really key part of the work I do, is I train people to tune out of that negative thinking before they drink, because it's the negative thinking that drives people to drink. You were terrible in that meeting, you know, the mums at the school gates, you know, all these things that can trigger this negative state of mind, and then, oh, I'll have that beer or that wine, and then all of a sudden that one goes into the two and the three. I help people train their brains to tune out of the negativity beforehand. So keep an emotional diary is important. Water, hydration.
Mm.
Because I've found sparkling water, using the Soda Stream at the moment to get some sparkling water,
yeah,
which has been really helpful for me, because I still feel like I'm drinking something.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's much healthier for you. Is New Zealand different to other parts of the world, or are we all very similar?
Oh, I love New Zealanders, because they love their wine just as much as the Aussies do. I mean, look, we live in a culture of drinking, and I don't think there's anything wrong with it.
Right.
I really genuinely do. It's just we've got it. I say there's two two different types of drinking. There's the emotional drinking, there's the conditional habitual drinking, and there's the pleasurable drinking.
Right.
So the bit that causes you the grief the next day and makes you feel not great about yourself, that's the bit I'm talking about.
Nice.
So that, you know, I encourage alcohol-free days. I think they're really important. You know, little things you can do with the program. I mean, the great thing about the seminar in one day, or obviously you could read the book, is that, you know, we're talking about walking out and drinking less that day. Getting it all done in one day is great, because we all deserve to like ourselves a little bit more without needing the alcohol.
Yeah. That obviously goes if, as long as you're not an alcoholic or a problem drinker. This is obviously what you're saying. That's a different category altogether, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, we're talking people who need to drink in the mornings, people who can't sustain a life without it. You know, we're talking about people who are not like that at all. We're talking, there's a middle ground of drinking that's out there, you know, that we need to work on for a lot of New Zealanders.
And that's what everyone says about New Zealand drinking, don't they? They say we've got a drinking culture that perhaps needs to change, and this is going to certainly help people if they start feeling bad about their drinking behaviour. In 7 days, you can change it, OK? So go to the seminar or get the book. It's brilliant.
Hey, thank Georgia, you. Thank you so much for stopping by.
Thank you for having me.
Georgia Foster is going to be delivering her seminars in Auckland and Wellington on August the 18th and the 19th. You can check out her website for more information about the seminars and bookings.
Might just take this home myself and have a wee read.